how to create virtual office hours in Collaborate Ultra.
Hi everyone, this is Toby. Those of you who have already begun using Collaborate Ultra in Blackboard have figured out that there's one thing that Collaborate Ultra currently lacks. It's something that Blackboard is working on, but they don't have it quite ready. Hopefully they will by the end of 2020. In the meantime, I'm going to show you a pretty easy workaround that's going to enable you to create virtual office hours sessions in which your students can join as guests. And it's not going to matter whether the students are actually enrolled in the course section where you create the virtual office hours session or sessions. Because all of them, whether or not they're students who are enrolled in a completely different course section that you're teaching, or advisees who are not enrolled in any of your sections, all of them are going to join this one single session using a guest link that you are going to either put on as a menu button on all of your course sections or from a link that you're going to email to your advisees. So I'm going to show you in this video how to do several things. First of all, we're going to pick a section and you're going to create a virtual office hours recurring session, which means that every week you're going to have a brand new session open up specifically for that week's virtual office hours. Then you're going to take the guest link from that session that you create and you're going to put a link to that session on all of the menu buttons for all of the course sections that you're teaching. You can also email it to your advisees. Then I'm going to show you how your students will come in as guests, come into the main room, which is going to serve as a waiting room, and one by one, you're going to pick those students and you're going to bring them into a breakout group so that you can meet with them privately. And then you bring the next student into your private little breakout group for your meeting. It sounds kind of complicated, but I'm going to walk you through the process step by step. And also, I want to make sure that you know that the step by step instructions are also written up in the instructor guide, which is linked in the description for this YouTube video. So if you're ready, let's get to it. In this first section, I'm going to walk you through the process of creating your virtual office hours recurring session. As you can see, I'm already inside the Blackboard tool, and I've done this by going to the link that I have set up for the students in this class just to open up the Collaborate tool. Alternatively, just so you know, you as a faculty member could also get to Collaborate from going to Course Tools and then clicking on Blackboard Collaborate Ultra. I do want to emphasize, however, that your students can never get to Blackboard Collaborate this way. Anything below course management, your students cannot access at all. So in this case, all I really wanted to do was just to launch the Blackboard Collaborate Ultra tool, which I've done. So I'm going to begin by creating my session. So I can click on either this button or that button up here that says Create Session, doesn't matter which one. And the first thing I'm going to do is give it a session title. Right now, in the event details, what I want to do is come down here and giving my example of a recurring session, I'm going to select Repeat Session. I want it to repeat weekly. And I wanted to begin on, let's say in this case, I'm going to begin on the 28th and I'm going to start it. Then I'm going to end it at 5 p.m. Before I continue, I just want to point one thing out. Even though the session itself is supposed to run from 3 o'clock to 5 o'clock, it's always a really good idea to add an extra 15 minutes to the end of any Collaborate session in case you need to wrap up with your last student meeting. So now I'm all set with that. And I want to end this after a specific date. In December on the 14th is going to be the last virtual office hours. I'm going to allow students to come in 15 minutes beforehand. The other thing that you want to do in event details is to click the checkbox for guest access. Then you're going to take this guest link and click copy. I'm going to open up Notepad and I'm going to paste that link because I'm going to need that for a step that we're going to do a little bit later when a link to this particular session is put on the course menu of every one of the course sections that you're teaching. So I'm just going to leave that in Notepad for later use and minimize it. Now I'm all set with my event details and I can save.
Next, I click on the gear icon to go into session settings. In this case, you're going to leave the attendee role alone because, in fact, in these sessions, everybody's going to come in as a guest. So most of these things you can probably just leave as is. And then when you're done, just click Create. Now I'm going to close this. And now I have my recurring session. Now you'll see that when I click this little down arrow, this is where it's going to show occurrences that have been set up. And the occurrences will not be available. They won't. You can't go into them until the specific date that's set. So on 9/28 at 3 p.m., this virtual office hours will become available. Next, I'm going to show you how to create a web link on the course menu to the virtual office hours recurring session that you created. You're going to replicate this web link on all of your Blackboard course sections. I'm going to go up to the very top of my menu, and this is something that you would do in every one of your class sections. It's good to be consistent. So I'm going to click on the Add Menu Item button. And then I'm going to click Web Link, and I'm going to say Join Virtual Office Hours. And now I'm going to paste that URL that I had copied, and it's very important to make this available to users. I'm going to click Submit, and notice that, as with all menu items that are created, it goes to the bottom. You are going to take your mouse, and you are going to drag this up to the top. I recommend putting it right below the announcements so it's easy for the students to see right away. If you have trouble working with a mouse, you can always use the keyboard reordering option to position it wherever you want on the menu. Now there's one last step here that's very important. You must click the little drop down and select Set Link to open in a new window, right? That's very important. Now I'm back on the My Institution page because I have to go into whatever other sections I want to have my students join virtual office hours, and I have to add that same virtual office hours link onto the course menu of all of my other course sections. So that is the workaround that you can use to have your students join your virtual office hours from any course section that they happen to be enrolled in. Now, let's say that they're not enrolled in any classes. How would you do this? Well, what you would do is you would send a message out to your advisees. You would say, join my virtual office hours every Monday from 3 to 5 p.m. by clicking this link. I also recommend that you tell your students very explicitly that they must enter their full name, first and last, because when they click on this guest link, they will be prompted only to enter their names. There's no password, nothing. They just go straight into the session. Now we're going to look at how you can use breakout groups, or in fact one group, within your Collaborate session to have a private meeting space for each of your meetings with your individual students. Okay, now let's say it's time for you to begin one of your virtual office hour sessions. What you're going to do is to go into the class where you actually created that virtual office hour session or the recurring sessions. So I'm going to go into my little sample class here, TK Training 7. Now, you are not going to click on the virtual office hours link, because if you do that, you're going to join as a guest, as your students would. You do not want to join as a guest. You need to join as a moderator. So you can either join by clicking the regular link that your students would use to get into Collaborate, or if you prefer, you can go down to Course Tools and you can click on the link that allows you as an instructor to launch the Collaborate tool. Either way will work. But you have to be in the course where you created the virtual office hours session. So here I am, here my virtual office hours recurring session, and now whichever session I want to start, which would be active because it would be the correct date and time, I would join that session and then I would be there in there as a moderator. My students, again, they will be coming in by clicking on this virtual office hours link, and they will join from whatever course section in which they are enrolled as a guest. You can see that I have two students, two participants listed here, Jane Doe and John Brown. And I'm going to bring them one at a time into a breakout room so that we can have a private session. And the one that I'm not talking to will remain in the main room. So to do that, I'm going to simply click on the little share content button. And then I'm going to start my breakout groups. Now you can see by default, you have two groups. You can just leave the two of them there. You're only going to use one of them, which is group one. First, I want to meet with John Brown. So I'm going to drag myself down to group one because I want to be in there. And then I'm going to drag John Brown into group one. So now Jane is alone in the main room and John and I are inside the breakout group, group one. So now I click start. And now both John and myself are going to be privately inside the group one breakout room, and we can have our private conversation. So you can see here's group one, and I'm in here as a moderator, and John is in here as a participant. Now, when John and I are all done meeting, John can leave the session. Don't expel John from the session or remove him. Just let him leave on his own. Otherwise, he will be blocked from returning if he needed to. Now I'm done meeting with John, so what I'm going to do is simply end this breakout group session and I'll return to the main room. So will John if he happens to still be in the session. And now what I want to do is I want to meet with Jane. So I'll replicate that process. I'll come down to share content. I'll click breakout groups. And this time I'm going to drag Jane and myself into group one. So now John is alone in the main room. He could leave if he wanted to. Now Jane and I are inside group one. I start the breakout room, and both Jane and myself are inside group one for our private meeting. And if other students had come in and were waiting in the main room, I would just continue to repeat this process. I would end the breakout group. I would return to the main room, and then I would drag the next student along with myself into the breakout session and continue along until I had met with all the students. And in case you're wondering where I got this cute little virtual office hours graphic, what I did was go into the Course Design and Delivery Competencies course, which all faculty are enrolled into, and then I went into the course content. I scrolled down to Managing Live Classes and open the folder for Collaborate Ultra. And in there, you will see this graphic. It's down towards the bottom here. Virtual Office Hours Main Room Graphic to Share. So it's just a PowerPoint. You can download it onto your computer. And then the way that you upload it into your main room in Collaborate is like this. Just join your session as a moderator. And then what you're going to do is go into Share Content, and then go into Share Files, click Add Files, navigate to the download that you put on your computer in Downloads, open it, and then click Share Now. That's all there is to it. Now, this graphic will show in your main room as soon as your students join in your Collaborate Virtual Office Hour session. If you have any questions, you can contact your local ed tech directors or refer to the instructions in the accompanying Collaborate Ultra training handout.